Obed, obviously that was a pretty nice pass there. Only a few minutes earlier, it looked like you could barely walk. I mean, what was the... did you think you were... Like, in a normal situation, would you have stayed in there or would you have asked for a sub?
I asked for a sub because I thought there was no point of me limping around on the field when we needed a goal. And so as soon as I felt the contact on that play, I was like, yeah, I'm going to be limping around for a little bit. And I don't know how much time. I think I looked at the clock, it was like 90th or 88th, I don't remember. And so I was like, better put someone on fresh than me. And there was no sub, so I had to stay around.
And so what was your thought process of, like, you looked like you limped through it for a little bit, but then you were able to get back into the game?
Yeah, I mean, it's just part of the game, you know? Once you take a hit sometimes, you know, you take a little bit to get back into it, but then, you know, just the game, like, I saw my team is, like, fighting, like, running, like, I wasn't going to be that one guy limping around, you know? Just I wanted to do it for the team, for my teammates, you know? And so that's what, like, gave me, you know, the motivation to, even though through the pain, like, keep running and keep working.
Well, what did you see on that pass? And I guess, how did it feel when you hit it?
Like any other pass, just look at where I want to hit it, and I hit it.
Obed, you had an opportunity to see the game change once the subs came in. Coach spoke about that. The dynamic of the game really shifted. But what are the things that you are noticing when those subs get made? Are you able to rely on them because they have fresher legs to kind of do a little bit more of the dirty work, or do you still keep your work rate?
I still keep my work rate no matter who's on the field. Maybe depending on who comes on, who the sub is, or what position they come in, maybe it will change a little bit. But, you know, having guys come on, you know, the quality that, you know, Raul has been offering, you know, Paul has been in great form. Like, it just motivates the team. It gives the team a different gear, a different look. And so we're just, you know, that's how we're going to win games, just having everyone be ready and giving everything.
Oh, but before Wednesday, you guys hadn't come back from 2-0 down all season. Now you do it twice in 4 days. What changed?
I mean, I wish we didn't have to come back twice, but like we spoke at halftime in Houston, our body language, like, we need to be more positive. We need to be keeping each other up. You know, someone makes a mistake, not, you know, push them down, instead bring them back up. And that way we can get some momentum going. And I think that's what we learned from Houston. So when we went 2-0 down, you know, our body language was different, and we were able to come back even though there was, like, I don't know, 25 minutes left in that game.
Last couple for Obed. Yeah.
Obed, one of the things that we have noticed is the body language, as you mentioned it, and it's something that we brought up early on through the stretch that you guys were having. However, that has been changing. What are some of the things that you guys have been doing, aside from what coaches tell you to do, to help you, you know, keep that positivity?
Poker, you know, celebrations like that, you know, just, you know, things we can do in the locker room, you know, crack jokes, music, things we can bond on, you know, Euros going on, watch those games together, all those little things we do together, just so it reflects on the field, even though sometimes, like, on the field it won't really show, but off the field we know we're all together, so on the field it's going to show at some point that, you know, we love each other, we're all brothers, and we're going to fight for each other on the field.
Obed, last one, emotions in this game, yet you seem to keep your cool and, you know, look very confident. What do you make of your form this season, and, you know, how are you liking your play right now?
It's been okay. I think I can still do a little bit more. There's little lapses maybe where I can do better. You know, I'm very critical of my performances. You know, every little thing that I do, especially when I make a mistake, that takes a toll on me a lot. Like, that will be what I remember for the rest of the game. And so working on those things, you know, letting things go, just moving on to the next play, I think is something that I can work on.
If you could pick one thing
last one, guys,
that you've improved the most in your opinion, what would that be this season?
Like I've said, I think I'm just playing free. I'm just having fun.